Students, as you know that we have started taking class on YouTube channel, my YouTube channel that is named as ER Naveen Gold. So you may find the video which I have uploaded yesterday. So students, from today onwards, we will start our new topic, that is pivot bearing and the collar bearing. So this topic is also in our syllabus named as design of pivot bearing and collar bearing. So students, first of all, we have introduced you about the pivot bearing. So what is pivot bearing? Pivot bearing is also known as footstep bearing. The other name of pivot bearing is footstep bearing. Okay. So dear students, in pivot bearing, pivot bearing is of three types basically. One is flat pivot bearing, and second one is conical pivot bearing, and third one is truncated pivot bearing. So first of all, you have to understand about pivot bearing. So pivot bearing is one of the type of bearing. And it supports vertical shafts, and its application is basically in shapes, turbines, etc. Okay, so it only support the vertical shaft. Okay, so if the shaft from the end point is flat and that shaft is supported by a bearing, that is known as flat pivot bearing. If the shaft from the end is not flat but the conical in shape and that is supported by the bearing, is known as conical pivot bearing. And third one is truncated pivot bearing. In the truncated pivot bearing, the shape for the shaft from the end point where the bearing is supported, the shaft, the shape is about tapered type. Shaft is about tapered type. So that type of bearing is known as truncated pivot bearing. Okay, and pivot bearing, there are we have to consider two cases. That is, one is uniform pressure, and second one is uniform wear. So students, we have already discussed about uniform pressure and uniform wear in clutch chapter, which we have already studied in automobile engineering book. Okay, so now we have go further and discuss about its design of pivot bearing. Okay, so when we design a pivot bearing, we have to make two assumptions. One is that there is uniform pressure, and second one is there is uniform wear. That means we have to assume that there is a uniform wear. That means the wear is uniform throughout the system or throughout the pivot bearing, or there is uniform pressure in the whole pivot bearing. Okay, so we have to take our first case, that is of uniform pressure. So this case is similar to the clutch case. Okay, in the clutch we also study this type of expression. Okay, where W is load acted on the shaft, as you seen in the figure, which I show you in my notes. Okay, so dear students, I will also show you by marking. So wait for it. Here in the diagram, okay, here in this diagram, W we have seen is known as the load, and R is the radius of the shaft, or we can say the radius of the radius of Bohr. Okay, so after that, so dear student, where P is showing the pressure per unit area, mu is coefficient of friction, and to take axial thrust of shaft, okay, this type of bearing or footstep bearing takes axial thrust of shaft, okay. We can say that every pivot bearing take axial thrust of the shaft. So pressure is equal to load per unit area. So you know that pressure is equal to force per unit area, okay. So you already know about this. So frictional torque. Frictional torque is equal to 2 by 3 mu pi mu p r cube, and that is equal to 2 by 3 mu w r. So this relation is also getting in multi-plate clutch or single plate clutch, okay. So after that, you better know about the formula of power, 2 pi mt divided by 60, and in the case of uniform wear, you know that pressure multiplied by radius is equal to constant, where P is equal to C by R, when C is constant and R is the radius. From the uniform wear case, we get the torque transmitted is equal to 1 by 2 mu WR, and you know that R is equal to what? In the upper case, in the case of uniform pressure, R is equal to R cube minus R square divided by R square, capital R square minus small r square, where capital R is the radius of outside diameter and small r is the radius of inside diameter, okay? So next case is collar bearing. So these about two formulas of uniform pressure and uniform wear are used in the designing of pivot bearing or finding out the torque and any other value. You see in the diagram, or it basically takes horizontal load, okay, it takes horizontal load. These bearing provided at any position along the shaft and bears the axial load of mating surface. These also take the axial load of mating surface, okay. So as you seen in the diagram, on the shaft there is a collar is made. This collar is known as single collar. We have put many collars on the shaft, so if we put one collar, that is known as single collar bearing, and we put number of collars, then we can say that one is multicollar bearing. So you get the point. So this one is also designed, the collar bearing is also designed. It is of two types, single collar bearing and multicollar bearing. So bearing is used to support load, uniform pressure, and in case of clutch, power transmission. Clutch is used for power transmission basically, and bearing is used to support the load, not for power transmission. So you have to differentiate between bearing and clutch. Clutch is used for transmission of power from one place to other place, or we can say that engage and disengage the power shaft with the driven shaft, or driver shaft with the driven shaft. Similarly, bearing is used to support the load, not for transmission or engaging, okay. Where I have used two terms, that is UPT and UWT. UPT is for uniform pressure theory and UWT is for uniform wear theory. So dear students, you may get the point, okay. After that, there is a numerical. So I don't write the statement of this numerical, and I have write only the given data. So here in this this given numerical, there is D inside is equal to 40 millimeter. D inside means inside diameter of the bearing, and D outside means outside diameter of the bearing is 100 millimeter, where P is 2 megapascal. And you know that in megapascal pressure, So this value is pressure. We have given pressure 2 megapascal, okay? And after that there is mu is given, that is coefficient of friction, and find frictional torque. So we have to find out the frictional torque, okay? So dear students, you know that we have some value and we have some formulas. So I have write a formula in this diagram or in this numerical, TF. So you know that what is TF? Frictional torque. TF is frictional torque is equal to 2 by 3 mu W multiplied by your bracket R cube R naught cube minus R inside cube divided by R naught square minus R inside square. Okay. So dear students, first you know that we have given outside diameter, we have given inside diameter, but we don't have the value of W, or we can say that we don't have the value of load. So W is taken from the formula of pressure. And what is the formula for pressure? Pressure is equal to low force per unit area. That means force means load. So P is equal to, we can write it as, from mouse is difficult, but P is equal to W divided by pi r square. Okay. So from here we can find out the value of W. Okay. How we can get? W is equal to P multiplied by pi r square. So by putting this value about, or replace the value of W from here, we get P into pi. Or you know that R is, what is the R here? R is outside diameter minus inside. So we put this value P R outside minus R inside and replace the value of W. So replace it and we will get the answer. But here we miss this value also. So this value is also putting here also same. So dear students, I think you may get the point. So by putting these all values, we will get the torque transmitted by the frictional torque. Okay. So after that, so another numerical, that is we have some given data. We have to find out the outside diameter, or sorry, we have to find out outside radius 2000 rpm, and the coefficient of friction is given 0.25. So here pressure is also given 1 megapascal, and radius inside diameter, inside radius is also given. So we have, from here you know that power is given, so in the second numerical we have some given data R naught, P, R naught and E and where P is power transmitted. Okay, this is not the load, power transmitted. So from here we can find out the torque transmitted, and after finding the torque transmitted, we have to find out the frictional torque. You know that we have the formula of frictional torque. From the formula of frictional torque, we can easily find out the outside radius. And there is also one more value also written, that is, you know that, that is what? R cube, sorry, R naught cube minus R inside divided by R naught square minus R inside square. So you will also put these values also, and after that you have to find out this R naught. Okay. This value is in multiplication with this complete value. Okay, so this may I have forget this written this value also. So you have to put this value also, and you may get the outside radius of this question, which we have to calculate. In the next numerical, we have the numerical for conical pivot bearing. Okay. So next numerical, so in next numerical we have seen some given data also, and there is a angle is also given, that is 2 alpha is given. So if 2 alpha is equal to 120 degree, we have to find out alpha. So alpha is equal to 120 by 2, that means 60 degree. And load is given, that is W is given, 20 kilonewton, or we can say that just load is given 20 kilonewton, okay, and pressure is given, speed of the shaft is given, D, and one condition is given, that outside diameter of the bearing is equal to 2 times of inside diameter, okay, and coefficient of friction is given. So from here, what we have to find out, we have to find out the value of inside diameter, outside diameter, but inside diameter and outside diameter. So from here, from the above formula, that is the formula of pressure, the pressure formula of pressure is equal to load divided by pi r outside square minus r inside square. So by putting these values, we will get the r inside and r outside easily. And after getting r inside, r outside, we also find out the torque transmitted or frictional torque. Okay. And we can also find out the power. If we have the value of torque, we also find out the power transmitted. Okay. Similarly, and in the next numerical, we have also find the value of. So in this numerical, a vertical shaft 140 millimeter diameter rotating at 120 rpm subjected to a flat pivot bearing. This is the case of flat pivot bearing, and the shaft causes a vertical load of 30 kilonewton. The coefficient of friction is mu is equal to 0.6. Estimate power loss. So power loss in friction nikalna hamare, power loss nikalna. So you know that we have given radius is equal to 70 millimeter, we have given speed 120 rpm and W 30 kilonewton, mu 0.6, and torque, and we have given the torque, we have the formula of torque calculation 2/3 mu WR. So by putting the whole values mu, W and R, we will get the we will easily get the answer of torque transmitted. Okay, formula of angular velocity 2 pi n divided by 60. So from here we will get the power. So from calculation we have get the answer is 84 newton meter. So and that's we can easily find out the power transmitted. What is the numericals also important for subject point of view. So students, I expect from you that you will learn and exercise your unsolved numerical as well as your solved numerical from your textbook or from your reference book, and you have to practice more and more on data design book for solving these type of numericals. Thank you. Till then, bye, and we will meet you in our next lecture. So